this episode brought to you by Noble Gold. Now, it's not often you get a gift for yourself in the holidays, is it? So, how does a free 22-karat American Gold Eagle coin sound? Not bad, huh? A free 22-karat American Gold Eagle coin in a special presentation box. But it's not that simple. To qualify, you have to take out a precious metals IRA or 401k rollover with Noble Gold. So call 877-646-5347 and get this special coin offer, but don't hang around. That's 877-646-5347.
The public is ill-served if we don't make it really clear what the stakes of this story are. How can a morning show not lead with this drama, I guess is what I'm saying.
And I'm sure you see a lot more than that since you're the chairman of the Intelligence Committee about what Russia is trying to do when it comes to misinformation or disinformation.
Tragically, the president is doing nothing to deter it, nothing to disrupt it, because he frankly wants the Russian help.
The FBI believes that Carter Page has been collaborating and conspiring with the Russian government. There is probable cause that such activities involve or are about to involve violations of the criminal statutes of the United States. The document accuses you of being a, quote, agent of a foreign power. Were you? Well, were you ever an agent of a foreign power? Did you ever advise the Kremlin or work with the Kremlin on anything? This isn't just Christopher Steele or James Comey. This is many, many people over two administrations, four judges appointed by Republicans over and over, believing that you are an agent of a foreign power. How do you respond to that? You've said that you went to Russia in the summer of 2016 to deliver a commencement address. Is it not a possibility that Russians were trying to recruit you, even if you didn't take the bait? Is that not possible? It seems to me like that would be their job, and you're working for Trump. You'd worked with the Kremlin in the past. That would be a reasonable thing for them to try to do.
You know, page 8, it says, it talks about disguised propaganda, including the planting of false or misleading articles, which is exactly what this is. So that's kind of the pot calling the kettle black.
Donald Trump's refusal to ever criticize, say anything wrong about Putin and the Russian government, and his willing to encourage interference on our elections. Donald Trump, if he had been impeached and actually the Senate got rid of him, it would have been a large message that to foreign countries, don't mess with the United States. Your tool, in this case, Donald Trump, is gone.
Uncomfortable questions moved into the mainstream in a big way. Trump's odd behavior with Vladimir Putin is compelling so many people to ask, what does Putin have on Trump? Has Trump been compromised? Those experts, those reporters, they are looking at the fact pattern and they're seeing something strange, even sinister. Think about this cable news screen, right? The banner is the same size, whether it says cat gets stuck in a tree or whether it says Trump might have committed treason.
Do you still believe the president could be a Russian asset?
I think it's possible.
And Fareed, what about the dynamic with our perceived enemies like Iran or Russia?
I think in general, there isn't going to be as much difference as people imagine. The Biden folks are pretty tough on Russia, Iran, North Korea. The dirty little secret about the Trump administration was that while Donald Trump had clearly had a kind of soft spot for Putin, the Trump administration was pretty tough on the Russians.
What the f***?
They armed Ukraine, they armed the Poles, they extended, NATO operations and exercises in ways that even the Obama administration had not done. They maintained the sanctions. So I don't think it will be that different.
Do you know what this means? Fareed just admitted the dirty secret, and that's the fact that Trump was actually tougher on Russia than Obama was. They have to admit this now because during a possible Biden regime, he's not going to change a damn thing, and they're going to have to explain their complete lack of outrage. In fact, Biden may end up just pulling military support from Ukraine, which was his policy during the Obama regime. While Trump sent over Javelin missile systems, which are a total game changer, and forced Russia to stop advancing out of fear of losing a lot of armor. The Obama administration sent them medical supplies and blankets. They refused to send them military supplies. And remember, Putin invaded Crimea during Obama and Joe Biden's tenure. The fact of the matter is, our media, the Democrats, and elements within our government purposely leaked and promoted the Steele dossier as soon as Trump took office, which kicked off the next 4 years of an attempted coup to undo the election. As it turns out, the Steele dossier was in fact Russian disinformation that was actually compiled from a Russian spy who the FBI had listed as a national security threat. The FBI spying on Carter Page and the Trump campaign were all driven by that document, and it all turned out to be bunk. The Russians also organized rallies that were both anti-Hillary and anti-Trump. It was the Democrat media like CNN and MSNBC that promoted those anti-Trump rallies, not the anti-Hillary ones. So when they talk about promoting Russian disinformation and undermining our institutions, they're really just talking about themselves and deflecting by accusing their opposition of that very thing. That's all for this one. I do want to apologize for the lack of content over the last couple weeks. I've just been busy with personal stuff and also working on some side projects like my new gaming community, Dad's Gaming, also pronounced Dadzy Gaming, a place for adult gamers to hang out, discuss your favorite topics, and play games with friends. Check out the description and pinned comment for links to that and more. Make sure to hit that like button on your way out, and I'll see you all next time.